My name is George. Born and brought up in Cameroon, from a tribe of Yabasi called Bandem. My father is a Nigerian. My mother is a Cameroonian. I decided to migrate so as to ameliorate not only my lifestyle, but the lifestyle of my people. And I've done my best to go to school and to help the downtrodden masses. I have got the concept of integration with the country harboring not only me, but others who are foreigners. And my dream is to go back home, finally, and elevate the conditions of the people. This is a pledge that has become a task, and a task that must be done.
Milano Centrale, for you, you know? Yeah, man. I love Milano so much, you know? So listen, let me tell you something now. Just look at this name now. This is the central of Milan. This is the central, the station where all the train, international, the national, all the train coming, going all over Italy. Here is the deal with the transportation. You know, I am a guy that always likes standing in the center at the heart of a city. I like to be in the center so that I know what is going on. You know, I know what I can know the history I can tell. Here, I don't like crime. But I always be in a midst where there is crime. But I don't like crime. You know, me, I being in the midst of the central like this, I'm seeing much things that the strangers did. Dealing with the drugs, man. There is a group of people, they're robbing, stealing thief in the supermarket. Many things that you can talk of that is crime is going on here. You know, but we see it. I forget the fuckers, they don't have a job, they're crying for a job. Yes, they don't find a job. Write it down. They have not find, they are not, and they are not serious to find a job. When you serious to get a job, you got it. Here in Italy, I look for the job and I got it. Many more look for the job, they got it. Them that don't want to work, the lazy ones, we know them. We know them.
We get something to tell them, you know. Black man life in Italy is something else.
Ando tako la gamento, chiede lavoro. Ando tako pretiva, chiede lavoro. Ando mi ha detto, non c'è lavoro. Ritorno a casa, patro chiede affitto. Mi amore, bisogno soldi. Mia tasca senza soldi. Come si vive senza lavoro? Bisogna lavorare. Bisogna, tutti quanti bisogna lavorare, come no? Radical.
Ciao!
Tomorrow, Enes, 7 o'clock, eh?
Le cane la chiede, nostro. Ah, ci sono tanti.
Abbiamo parlato con il direttore, ma lei non può che
se non è un
si
sta parlando.
Secondo me sono due punti, no? Cioè, nel senso che la domenica, la festa, in questo momento è diciamo un incontro di lavoratori sani che vogliono ritrovarsi, ritrovarsi. Se no, altri giorni, in un certo momento, cambia l'atmosfera, cambia totalmente dalla A estremità, dalla A alla Z. Adesso come adesso è tutta una questione di famiglie, di incontro, posso anche dire di contaminazione, perché in fondo non è soltanto gente di una certa regione, di una certa città. Io sono senegalese, per esempio, però mi trovo bene, sto bene, vengo qui, cioè tranquillo. Si sa, a un certo momento qui diventa proprio una cosa oscena, uno schifo. Ora, secondo me, è bellissimo, stupendo, tutto lì.
Vas-y.
Ouais.
Moi je
donc,
pense que. Ouais, ok.
Action.
Andiamo. Le premier plan qui est arrivé.
Intégration à travers la culture.
À travers
réponds.
La culture. Il faudrait que.
Tu as 5 minutes.
Il faudrait que toutes les portes soient ouvertes quand même aux blancs et aux noirs pour qu'on puisse se mixer. Mixer, ça veut dire quoi? Ça veut dire moi je vais vers toi pour connaître ta culture. Toi tu viens vers moi pour connaître ma culture. À travers ça, on commence à se connaître. La communication, on pourra communiquer. Le premier plan d'abord, ça veut dire quoi? Communiquer. Ça d'abord c'est un point beaucoup important, communiquer. Mais moi je pense que la majeure partie des hommes qui
sont... Il faut regarder notre caméra.
Nos rapports entre les blancs et les soi-disant extra-communautaires, il y a des choses qui sont trop masquées.
Après la communication, on commence à s'accepter et on commence à se fréquenter. Au fur et à mesure du temps, on va s'accepter et puis on va de l'avant. La culture est bien, on se change la culture. Parce que moi j'ai quelque chose de bien que lui n'a pas, lui a quelque chose de bien que moi je n'ai pas. On fait un message et puis on arrive à quelque chose de bien fondé. Et je comprends un peu.
Non, avec mes entourages, le peuple africain ou en général,
nous, les mêmes problèmes.
On est tranquille.
Parce qu'on a les mêmes problèmes.
On se ressemble, c'est dans notre problème.
Nous, on se réunit ici, on s'associe à nos douleurs, on se compatisse à nos douleurs. Ça,
je peux dire, du côté africain, c'est beaucoup, c'est un rapport plus de fraternité, et tu vois. Voilà. Maintenant, par rapport à mes amis peut-être européens, c'est un rapport d'amitié, mais d'un appétit bref. Peut-être ça peut être d'intérêt par rapport à un truc, mais Peut-être c'est une amitié bref. Ça ne peut pas être une amitié approfondie. Peut-être qu'il y a toujours cette barrière-là. Et souvent un peu.
Mais entre vous, les Africains, est-ce qu'il y a l'entente?
Qui peuvent nous sauver? C'est le Seigneur seulement qui peut nous sauver.
C'est le Seigneur, hein?
Oui, c'est le Seigneur okay. qui peut nous sauver.
Ça va.
Ce n'est pas l'être humain qui peut nous sauver. D'autant plus, même ils savent tout ce qui se passe en Afrique et ne le font pas.
Deuxième point.
D'abord, il faudrait d'abord qu'ils cherchent à détruire tous ces dictateurs africains qui sont là-bas.
Ok.
Et ne plus envoyer les armes là-bas.
Ok.
Aujourd'hui, on est au 21e siècle. Il faut qu'on s'approche, okay. on s'unisse pour aller de l'avant dans tout le monde.
Ok.
Hébreux, tout le monde. À boire les bières ensemble, à fêter, à jouer dans la tristesse, dans le malheur, tout. Et on s'accepte comme ça, on est ensemble.
Est-ce que tu aimerais voir ta photo dans l'histoire et la photo de ta famille et les autres de tes enfants?
J'aimerais voir ma photo. Tous les combattants, j'aimerais voir la photo de tous les combattants.
Donc tu aimes trop la photographie aussi?
J'aime qu'il est comme ça, qu'on nous considère comme des personnes vivantes.
Okay,
qu'on ne nous considère pas comme des animaux.
Je l'apprécie quand même à la juste valeur, puisque peut-être je ne suis pas trop tendant dans ce domaine-là. Le domaine musical.
Mais tu apprécies quand même.
Je l'apprécie.
Tu aimes toujours avoir ta photographie comme ça dans le monde.
Un peu de privacy. Mamie, sono in diretta. Io sono in diretta, mi viene a disturbare.
I love women. That's my problem. Everybody getting on, the thing what they choose for this word. Me to a live woman. Why? Because I'm strong man. I'm man will be salty, say, I'm salty, say, not be straight, I'm educated, but I have my own brain or my own sense. I know how I'm doing, I'm working, but I get feeling for woman. That's my point. Everybody getting on.
Either black or white woman.
Especially I like black woman. Because I'm a black, I'm from Africa. I love my sisters.
How was your experience in Milan?
My experience was only fighting for Milan, for fighting, destroying bottle for my head, everything, okay? And also, gossip for Nigeria people, you understand me? No progress for them, it's finished.
I'm from Africa, I know the African culture, and especially with my country, Ghana. I'm from Ghana. I like any different games. Especially I like football. I like boxing. That's the point. Only just sport and I like it for my life.
Do you love arts?
No.
You don't love arts?
No.
C'est là le cinématographe, le cameraman. Est-ce que tu aimes l'art? Et qu'est-ce qui t'a donné la confiance d'aimer l'art, le monde d'art? Raconte.
Moi, je crois que sans l'art, on ne peut pas vivre parce que tout est une question de tout est une question de d'interaction. Parce que quand on parle de l'art, je vois que ça englobe tout. Ça englobe tout. Sans l'art, vraiment, le monde ne serait pas monde parce que
The train station is like the motor park, it's like the airport, which means it is a boundary, it's a meeting point whereby we can use the word jamboree, a place of merry meeting. For lonely people and people of curiosity, And people who want to have the spirit of awareness of what is happening. So if you have the love of the common people, you must be there. And if you want to undergo research intellectually, you must be there. So to have the spirit of awareness. But be aware of the positive part and the negative part. 1212.
Wayfaring stranger, while journeying through this world of woe, and there's no sickness, no toil, no danger.
Yeah, there are two things in life, man. Is it that you're a man or you're a soldier? Is it that you're a man or you're a woman? If you're a woman, it's cool, but if you're a man, there are two things involved. Is it that you're a soldier or you're a civilian? If you're a civilian, it's good, but if you're a soldier, there are two things involved. Is it that you're in the war fighting or you're in the office writing? If you're in the office writing, it's cool, but if you're in the war fighting, there are two things involved. It's either you kill someone or someone kills you. If you kill someone, it's cool. But if someone should kill you, there are two things involved. It's either they bring you home to bury you or they bury where they kill you. If they bring you home to bury you, it's cool. But if they bury where they kill you, there are two things involved. It's either they convert you to a manure to plant flowers or they convert you to a manure to plant trees. They convert you to a manure to plant flowers, it's cool. They might use you for love, gift, and every other thing. So if they convert you to a manure to plant trees, there are two things involved. It's either they use you for a tissue paper or they use you for an exercise book. If they use you for an exercise book, they can use you to write application for jobs or love letters. But if they use you for a tissue paper, there are two things involved. It's either a man use you for behind or the woman use you for, I reserve my comment.
Hey, two things.
Two things in life.
Yeah, that is a fasting dedicated question, you know.
Either you die or you leave.
Bastard.
Yeah, Central is where every motherfucker's out the street just spit fire. That's the hustling ground for every motherfucking soldier that calls himself a soldier, man. So, any more questions, soldier? Tell the stories, man. A lot of people come and go. Some came to make money, while some came, they're still there. Not moving forward, not moving backward. They're just stagnant. That's all about Centrale. That's Centrale is a place where all demons gather. Demons from different places from different parts of the world, different parts of the nations. That is where it's called Centrale. That's where you see every kind of demon you can imagine. You understand? So that's it, man. I don't give a fuck about no motherfucker out there. I'm just a soldier, man, a straight up soldier. Hello. Yeah, what the fuck is this? one thing, people tend to say the sky is their limit when it's not. There's something more than the sky. Because the moment you begin to think and you begin to elaborate, you begin to see more into the future. Now you tasted poverty in the past and later became rich. And you know what poverty really is in life. You as a man wouldn't want to treat anybody poor, evil. You want to show that love. You want to show that care. You want to administer everything to that person because you've tasted it before and you know what it's like to be in that person's condition. I always treat people that are poor, the less privileged. I'll treat them with respect and make them come up to the stage I am. Bang, bang, bang. I tell you, tomorrow, if I have the power and the privilege, I'll kill a lot of rich men, take possession of their money and share it to the poor. And make them feel what it means to be poor.
My name is Franklin Reagan Techi from Ghana, and I'm here in Milan. I came to Milan a week ago, and I'm here for a purpose. The reason why I'm Milan here, I'm a guy who I traveled to Japan at 2004. Sorry, a year 2000, July. And I was married to a Japanese woman, which Japan immigration gave me 1 year visa. And now I'm going to talk about why I'm sitting on this wheelchair. Immigration gave me 1 year visa to stay. And before the 1 year visa is going to expire, I submit an application to the immigration to renew my visa. And during my application is pending at immigration, I got divorced with my wife. So immigration told me to wait for a while before they will give me the results. So during my waiting, I got arrested by a Japanese police, which they put charge on me that my visa was expired. So I violation against the immigration rule. So police put me under arrest and I was detained by. So a week later, after my detaining, police came and asked me for medical checkup where I was not sick. Police told me that it's Japan police duty to do so. So I became agree with them. So they took me to the hospital nearby and a hospital which called Suzuki Clinic in Tokyo, the area called Azabu Juban. So when we got to the hospital, the doctor came and get my blood. And after get my blood, he entered some room. Within the 3 minutes, he came and told me that he have to give me injection because my health is not good. So the police bring me back to the police station. There, when we got into the police station, the police told me that they're going to change my room to separate me from the other inmates. So there I asked them that why. The police answered to me that the doctor have given them a medicine to be given to me 3 times a day. And during the time I'm taking the drugs, I cannot stay with other inmates. So that very day, after taking my sabah, this give me the drugs, which was 2 different powder and 3 different tablets. When I was taking the drug, after 2 weeks, I start going to the bloody. When I go to toilet, all what I see is blood. So there I start complaining to the police that no, something is going on, so I need a medical. The police even just come and laugh at me and insult me. You Africa from Ghana, you go back to your country. And so many insults. So whenever I asked for medical, they didn't even listen to me. So finally, or in short, in February 2003, 14 February, I wake up in the morning, I try to go to the washroom. I was not able to stand. All my body was shake, so I fell down. So that's at once I became paralyzed with from my waist to down. And that was my end. I was not able to walk again. They took me to the court for Tokyo District Court. I went to the court for 19 times for overstay charge. And my 19th times, the judge even judged me to guilty to go to prison, 1 year, 2 months in prison. So there I make appeal to the High Court. The High Court also give me same sentence. Last year, 2005, 14th March, they deport me back to Ghana with accompany of three Japanese immigration. My life was totally bad and I have nobody to help me. So I find a way to come to Europe for European Union to help me for my right to be done. So I'm here for justice to done in this case I'm suffering for.
Staring at the wall to Marine. They get me staring at the wall to Marine. Come on, baby, scream the God. I can hear you. I can hear you. This time of death. Getting high, watch the town fly.
We have good news. The biggest hotel in Milan has bought a new hotel. Albergo in Italian.
And this business empire has
extended and it has bought a new one, which is a unit of this empire. You could call it a one star or five star. But the most important thing, people get sleep and they wake up. This big hotel, the five star hotel, has been acquired and bought by this big hotel over here, Hotel Gallia. And I, as the manager of this hotel, we are thinking of buying more of them. Thank you.
Hello, hello, Italia.
No,
Prodi, good.
No, this is new. Just like
Berlusconi, good. Italia, forza! One, two, Prodio, 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 dopo domani, Prodio, tutta giornata, oh, marca da polo, niente lavoro, tutta giornata, oh,
niente,
postura, per mese del giorno, cambia Italia, oh, a Milano, Sindaco Licia, Sindaco Licia, bene.
It's a nice match, Italian-Ghana.
there are some of the Ghanaian players that have been praying for a very long time to play with the Italian, like Appia. I pray for them to play a nice match, and who is the più forte vince? Quella più forte vince.
The Cameroon football is based upon the name of the team, Indomitable Lions. We play with determination because determination plus ability leads to success. The spirit of a Cameroonian is to win, not to participate. And that is the only message. I was born and brought up in Cameroon, Hospedala Kintini. We played here with violence and power, and that's the spirit of African football.
I thought we could see extra time, and I thought we could see penalties.
It's going to be Grosso.
Yep. Fabio Grosso. Lippi knows that this is the moment for a young defender. The young man here from Palermo. To win Italy the World Cup. He does it! It's Italy's cup!
I say it! Forza! Forza! Forza Italia! Forza! Let's go this way. Let's go this way. I show my donor. I made them crazy in my school. Yes!
So we like this guy to come to Italy so that you see.
How many people?
Vraiment, vraiment, nous sommes très contents parce que bon, on ne croyait pas que l'Italie devait gagner. Alors, suivant l'histoire du football, du match entre l'Italie et la France, on dit souvent que c'est la France qui gagne, c'est la France qui gagne l'Italie. Il y a 27 ans, c'est toujours la France qui gagne. Aujourd'hui, nous avons fait une grande surprise, on ne croyait pas, mais on a changé l'histoire. Mais l'Italie, c'est le champion du monde pour le moment, donc rien à signaler.
Yes, I like Italy because I'm eating in Italy and I'm working in Italy. So I like to see this World Cup. Look, I try to see, but I struggle. I know that this Italy is a country that if I enter, I will see the World Cup. And through God, I see the World Cup. I know this World Cup will come in Giomo. Then I will see, let me eat my egg before. Hey, please keep quiet and see this egg. It's a blessing for Italy.
I put OZNY on the DKNY. Miami DC, confirmed with my cheeks. All Philly hoes know it's Moschino. I'm the cutie with the booty more than Gucci. I'm the real one. Meaning who's running the shit?
Hey, how ya?
The first time I met the train station, I was very, very happy because I met the citizens and I met the foreigners and above all, I met human beings. These three cardinal points. I was very, very delightful upon what I met for my first time. For me, particularly, the train station is made for people to mobilize themselves, go to various destinations, change their lifestyle, enjoy themselves, and make sure that their dreams come to reality. It is not meant for a place whereby you can come and see bottles being broken, drug pushers, beggars, killing and stealing, or this and that. I don't think it's an identity for the African people. This is no identity. Our identity is one. We are Africans diffused around the world, for there is no way you can go without seeing an African. Look at my people, they live in the way they like. And when they turn around, when they drinking, and when we got the courage, and then when we see them, and then when we walk for them, and I see my people, meanwhile I love the people. Joseph! No, no, we won't guess. You know, 12.
Kaba, open the
call for my people. Shit. My friend, they come from train station, me meet train, they travel.
You know, they get. Me, we carry go train station.
I cannot.
We carry go train station. Come on, don't get up.
Come on, wake up.
Come on, don't get up. Come on, don't get up.
Come
on, don't get up.
They see God for some prayer. They want to command.
This is a good man. This is a good man. Kaba is a good man. He's a good man. Everybody testify.
Kaba. Hey! Kaba! Kaba! Oh, Jesus Christ! Kaba! No! Kaba! Hey! Kaba! Hey! 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 God! Jesus! Oh God! Oh God! Kaba! No!
Kaba, you don't hear me, so I don't tell you. I dey tell you, Kaba. Come, Baba, we dey go. Kaba, Kaba, you know they hear me. Hey, Kaba, 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 na your sister, oh, Katrina. Kaba, come on, Kaba, come back. We dey tell you to come. Kaba.
Now and forever. In the name of the Father, the Son, the Holy Spirit, we pray.
My document in this Italy today, Kaba is the one who do it for me.
God bless you.
So many help, many things. Even till tomorrow, he's still helping me. So it's very painful for his death. Very painful to me. I lose something. I lose a very big thing in my life. Understand? May her soul rest in perfect peace.
Amen.
Principalmente, la stazione centrale non ha per lui venire a commercializzare, nel senso che erano anni che frequentavo questo posto qua. Ha dato la mano a tantissime persone. Lui, per non perdere questo rapporto con la stazione centrale, si è organizzato questo guadagnare da vivere. Tutte le sere da qua, a vendere, freddo, caldo, tutto quanto, lui era qua.
The pepper is very hot, eh? Is this thing I'm doing to survive my life? All these things. This one is beer. It's 3 carton. This one is rice and chicken with soup. It's inside here. Here is pepper soup. They call it tripa, but we call it shake. So people eat it with bread, panini. When I start this business, I have been looking for work over some years. I didn't get work. So I look around. I don't know what to do. I have to start this business. I reach here around 7 o'clock in the evening. I finish in the morning, 5 o'clock or 6 o'clock in the morning. You know one funny thing? One funny thing is that I resemble my mother. My mother have a restaurant before, so I take it from my mother. Do you need a beer? I love my mother so much. So when I come here, I didn't see my mother. I didn't hear from my mother. So I have to tell people my name is Nneka, because I too love my mother. Nneka mean mother is a mother terminal. Nneka, mother is than all. So I like the name.
Mother is everything.
So people started calling me Nneka. But my real name is Ndubego. Life is money. My people call me Ego. My late husband in Nigeria call me Ego Neku. But Midis Piachi, he has gone.
Ego Neku, money talks.
I love to hear from them always, both my children, even my daughter. I give my daughter one...
one fiancé.
I give my daughter one
fiancé. Like me, you know? Yeah, I'm okay, man.
Tell us, who's this guy? Tell us.
This guy come from Abriba.
Yes.
He come from Abriba in Abia State. Abriba and Isukwato, it's almost the same. So I take him like my in-law. Many years ago, I didn't see my family. So I want to travel to January to Abba State to go and see them. If I see them, if I come, maybe I have to see work, I change work. If I didn't see work, I continue with this. But before I will continue with this, I need a car. I will move with car because this work is not easy. So I need small car. But I don't know how to drive. So if I went to Nigeria, my brother
we learned me how to drive. When I enter Italy again, I will go driving school and collect my patente. If I collect my patente, I continue my work. I have to give them now 7 euro because the beer is 150, 150. I have to give them 7 euro. They are my customers, eh? I love them. I love Moroccano because they always help me to buy something to help my family. And they tell me that I'm a nice woman. If they didn't see me, they can't buy for another person.
Ancora due?
No, adesso caro.
No, non è caro. Un euro questa. Cosa?
Ma io non ce l'ho un euro.
Dimmi, fai qualche.
Okay, take.
Nigeria.
A post.
Thank.
Okay. Okay. Ciao. Ciao. I want to tell my family that I love them so much, all of them, from A to Z. I love them too much. I cover myself very well because cold is too much. I don't like winter. I like summertime. You know, summertime, everybody free. You dress and how you like. But cold time, you pack up clothes inside your body. You turn to bone black.
I've been in Italy for approximately 7 days today, and actually you are the first Italian person that I've, yeah, for real, you know, in 7 days. And this is very unusual, you know. I travel a lot and I make a lot of friends in the course of my traveling, you know.
Yeah.
And it goes to say a lot about this experience I'm having this time around, you know, because I've been in Italy for 7 days, like I say, and you are the first Italian that I'm relating with. And that is strange for me.
Hello, Todd. Hello, Todd. Hello, Todd. Hey, how are you doing? I'm in Hilton Hotel. Hilton. Don't you know Hilton Hotel?
Explain them what Ogogoro is.
Ogogoro?
Wait, go.
Ogogoro is what Italians call grappa. Then we call it Ogogoro and they call it grappa.
Understand me. I thank you people so much for the interview. Till next time we can see again. Pedro the Dog. You know, you can see my cross in Calvary where Jesus died for all building, you know, for all fucking human being, where Jesus died for our sin, you know. I respect the guy so much because he saved our soul in the world. We live in the world, you know, so free, we do what we can. You ask God for forgiveness, he forgive you, you know. So I still live my life, you know, as I want it. But I don't need a fucking human being, you know, to distract me, to man, discourage me or woman faith to tell me to do. I will still remain strong as a strong soldier for life, and I respect the West side.
Next.
One of these people, they even get drained to feed themselves.
No, no. Yes. No, no. Is me?
Is you. Yeah.
Oh. Oh, sometimes I'm very beautiful, nice, eh?
Yeah.
Yeah?
You are. You see, eh? Look. Mm. If you go closer, you see your face very big. Mm. Go closer.
Make big, bigger. Mm. Ah, this is me. Mm. Oh, nice, eh?
Yes.